that intention was killing the person. Really, we are so, so sorry. We are so, so sorry for the loss of that life. But however, we have to condemn the organizers of this demonstration.
The deceased has been identified as Tuhai Semugisa, a 25-year-old and a boda-boda operator in Muhoro Town Council in Kagadi District. The speeding vehicle registration number UG6998M was heading to Ndaiga.
My relative has just been knocked dead on this road by the speeding district vehicle. Government should intervene immediately.
According to residents, the Muhoro Ndaiga Road has spent around 4 years without any rehabilitation, yet it's a key route for traders.
I'm urging them to actually present a petition to the Minister of Works so that that road can be prioritized. It is a very, very important road that cannot be ignored.
We are really tired of the poor state of the roads that are full of potholes. Expectant mothers die while being taken to hospital, and school children fall into stagnant water whenever it rains. Now they have killed one of our own. We are really tired. Our members of parliament, Barnabas Tinkasimiri and Jennifer Chomhendo, you've not helped us enough. Even the district officials.
Lilian Ruteraho, the resident district commissioner in Kagadi, says the demonstration was unlawful because they did not receive any official communication regarding the demonstration. The RDC faulted the police for not handling the situation on time. However, she assured residents that the hunt for the hit-and-run driver is on.
But we are aware of where about the driver is, and we are trying to get him well. Instead of now causing another accident, we are just monitoring his movements right away, and we are going to get him anytime from now.
This at 1 kilometer Muhoro Chaterekera Ndaiga Road connects 5 sub-counties of Kagadi District to Lake Albert and the Democratic Republic of Congo. In the 2015-2016 national budget framework paper, a total of 400 kilometers equivalent of the gravel national roads were considered for tarmac, and Muhoro Ndaiga Road was inclusive. However, this was never achieved, and since then, no works have been going on this road. The body of the deceased was taken to the Kagadi mortuary for postmortem. Report by Thomas Tumwembaze for the news.